Gun disarms that I see on video that work in real life have three things. They're simple, they're fast, and they're full throttle. Today's video is brought to you by the generosity of Newbold targets. Newbold targets are self-sealing, reactive polymer targets that act like steel targets for training and practice, but are safer than steel. They allow bullets to pass completely through the target without ricochet or lead splatter. Check out their links in the description and thank them for bringing us today's video. Hi everyone, this is John with today's active self-protection lesson. I literally have zero background information on this one. It was sent to me by a fan from WhatsApp and I have no information on it. So if you have any information, please put it in a comment and I will add it to the description. Here we're going to see an armed robbery with a clerk behind the counter who just is not having it. Robbery's already in place and going on when the clerk's gonna go try to grab a gun, but the dude puts a gun right up in front of him, he puts his away and grabs that guy's, and then just walks off with it. It happened so fast, let's watch it again one more time. You can see the clerk here go for a gun up on the counter, and as he grabs his, the dude sticks a gun in his face, so he puts it in his waistband, grabs that guy's gun, and then just waltzes off with it. That's over. Seems almost nonchalant to me. He's just like, give me that gun and get the heck out of here, pal. Which is kind of funny if you think about it. I have a poll question for you out of this one. Have you trained on the mat in gun disarms? Have you spent any significant time training in actual gun disarms, particularly with a resisting opponent? Tell me what you think in the poll, whether you have or not. Me, yes, I have. We haven't spent as much time on it as some other things, but I definitely have spent some time with empty-handed skills in gun disarms. Out of this particular video, I want to talk first and foremost about an attitude of self-defense and why attitude is always first. Secondly, I want to talk about how the counter affects things in an armed robbery. And third, about disarms and empty-handed skills against an armed attacker. So much to say in such a short time here. First of all, notice that the clerk is going for a gun that's on the counter. I generally do not recommend staged firearms, even in convenience stores or stuff like that. I get having a gun in the store for the protection of employees, but a firearm that is over on the counter is not fast enough to get to, and you are at an incredible deficit. If the gun is not on your person, you probably will not have time to use it. So I don't recommend staging a firearm. And I actually say the same thing about, you know, in the home as a general thing. What's on your person will get used. Notice he's got the gun in his hand, but that guy's got a gun right on top of him. So that's, you know, stored gun, the gun that's staged, was of absolutely no use to him. That's the honest truth. Because if the guy that was robbing him in his store wanted to have a gunfight with him and wanted to beat him to the shot, he is absolutely beaten here. So the only reason he won this is because the guy wasn't willing to pull the trigger. So a staged firearm, you gotta know you cannot draw or grab from the drop. That's this bottom line here, friends. You cannot grab a gun from the drop. So he puts his gun away, and now what's he going to do? Because he has to grab this gun. So now, in a big sense, he's unarmed again against an armed attacker. Well, the first thing you have to do is close the distance, but you recognize that there is a countertop here. So the countertop in the armed robbery is a significant issue because you can't close the distance with the guy, but thankfully in this instance, the guy closed the distance for you and actually put the gun on the other side of the counter. So the distance is closed. Now it's all about that deflect and dominate. So you see him deflect the muzzle up and away from himself. So if the gun went off, it was not going to hurt him. Very smart there. Now you notice that he's got a hold not just of the barrel of the gun, but the guy's hand. Well, that's the second worst thing. You know, if you're gonna grab the gun, I'd rather grab the hand with the gun, grab the arm with the gun, and I'd rather grab it with both hands, if at all possible, because the next thing after deflect is dominate. You have to dominate the tool. Now, normally after that, we would say distract. However, not a whole lot of distraction here. And what he does, though, is use the counter as leverage. So since he had leverage there, his strength was able to overcome it. So instead of the distraction, what we had there was such a strength advantage that he was able to overcome not distracting him just because he had that big of a size disparity. Now he disarms, and now we say disable. The one thing I would say here is he just kind of casually walks off after he has the guy's gun. Now you might say, well, he can't hurt him anymore, so that is a form of disable, and that's good. That said though, I would recommend get out of the danger zone as fast as you can so that you're not at danger in case he had a friend with a gun or in case he had a second tool on him. All things considered, man, I think this clerk is he's kind of a bad dude, man. Had an incredible attitude, had enough skills, had a good plan, covered his ass.